Langlade students. I am here with Mrs. Corson, our literacy coach, and we told you something big was coming, and we're so excited to announce the arrival of our One School, One Book initiative. So today, every family is going to be getting a copy of the book, Because of the Rabbit, by Cynthia Lord. We really want to thank our PTO for sponsoring this event for students. So you'll notice on your front page, when you turn the page, there's a sticker that recognizes the PTO and thanks them because they help sponsor this for us. Because of the Rabbit is a great story, and we are excited that our entire school gets to read a book together. Mrs. Corson, do you want to tell them more about that?
I do. So, when you get your book, you are also going to get something called a Family Fun Pack. And in here, there's some tips for your families on how you guys can make reading together fun. And there's also a bingo game. Now, this is going to be really exciting because if you read the book with your family and do some of these activities, if you get 3 bingos and you bring this back to school to show us, you are going to get entered for a really exciting prize.
It's a 3-foot-tall stuffed bunny. Here's a picture of it. Now, Mrs. Corson, I have a question. Could it be like 1 up-down bingo and 2 horizontal? Or could it just be 5 in a row any which way?
I think it could be 5 in a row any which way, if it goes up and down or sideways or diagonal.
How fun. This is so exciting. Boys and girls, now sometimes life gets a little bit busy and a little bit crazy, and you might find that your family didn't have time to read that week. Well, we understand that happens, so we are also recording the entire book. You'll get to watch me reading to you, and then you can always listen to it if you're not able to read with your family on any particular week.
We are so excited that this is something our whole school, everyone here, is going to get to participate in.
So you're going to get your book from your teacher today. It is your book to keep, so you can go ahead and write your family name on it. Now, if you have siblings that go to school here, it's the youngest sibling that's going to get it and bring it home. So if you're a 5th grader and you're thinking, hey, I didn't get a book, I bet it's because your younger brother or sister got it. So, but you could write your family name on it, like I might write Mrs. Wojcik or the Wojcik family on mine, and then bring it home with the Family Fun Packet, and we're going to start reading for next week. Thank you.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong. Oh.
my name is Mrs. Durain. I am a kindergarten teacher here at Langlade. One of my favorite children's author is Mo Willems. He has lots of books, and I really like his series with Piggy and Elephant. This one is one of my favorites. It's called There's a Bird on Your Head. Fun fact about me is I started teaching here 8 years ago, and completely out of chance, my sister also started here at Langlade.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Katie. I'm Mrs. Durain's sister, and I'm a sign language interpreter here. A fun fact about me is that Mrs. Durain's husband and my husband also work together at a different building.
When I was in Mrs. Pearlberg's class this week, they asked that the animal of the week be the proboscis monkey. Now, the thing that stands out most about this monkey is that very large nose, but a female's nose isn't quite as big. The reason the male has such a large nose is it causes their calls to echo, and so they can attract a female mate. But there's a lot more interesting things about these monkeys. They are only found in one part of the world, on the island of Borneo, and they are very prolific swimmers. They'll actually belly flop and do flips and tricks into the water up from trees. They tend to be about 50 pounds in size, and they are a close-knit community. They like to live with other proboscis monkeys. However, they are threatened because the mangrove habitat that they live in is being cut down, so they are currently endangered.